Good evening, listeners. This is the Northeastern Service of All India Radio, broadcasting from Shillong on FM 100.1 MHz and AIR live streaming, as well as on ARDTH. And we are back with a very special live radio bridge program that goes out every first Friday evening. To welcome you all to the live radio bridge program, connecting the different states of the Northeast, and the topic of our discussion this evening is cultural exchange for better relations and development of the Northeastern region. Let me introduce all our resource persons. From Imphal, we have Mr. Aribam Sivadas Sharma, who is the Director, Arts and Culture Department, Government of Manipur. I have Mrs. D. Kharjana, who is an archivist, audiovisual art and culture department, government of Meghalaya. Mr. Swapna Lil Barua, former Commoner Department of Cultural Affairs, government of Assam, Guwahati. And lastly, we have Mr. Hovital Sotu, who is the project director, music task force, government of Nagaland, Kohima. A very good evening to each and every one of you, and welcome to the discussion. The Northeastern states have distinct cultures and multiple ethnic groups. Exactly. Having all this treasure within us, we need to move forward and explore new horizons for better relations and development of the Northeastern region. And this is the right platform to have a better understanding of what we call as cultural exchange. I would like to begin today's discussion with a quote by Mahatma Gandhi. And I quote, "A nation's culture resides in the hearts and in the soul of its people." In our discussion this evening, we have panelists and experts, as I mentioned, representing various states of the Northeast, and we look forward to a heart and soul enriching deliberation as we take a closer look at our different cultures and its relevance and furthermore. Well, at the very outset, I would pose this question to my resource person here sitting beside me. Well, what would be the main goal or the objectives that one needs to consider when we talk about cultural exchange?
As we understand cultural exchange, any mutual sharing of information for the purpose of improving friendship and understanding. So the goal is to have this unity among all the Northeastern states through culture, so that we can explore cultures like traditions, customs, beliefs, societies, languages, and much more.
I would like to ask from the other panelists, I hope all of you are rightly connected to us. Our panelists from Imphal, Mr. Aribam.
Yes, ma'am.
What would you like to mention about the term cultural exchange?
Yes, cultural exchange itself is, in my term, culture in simple language is the cumulative behavioral pattern of the society brought down from generation and passed to generation next. It includes moral, customary, traditional, ritual, attire, entertainment, communication, and sharing aspects. Of course, all the Northeastern states have, as Madam has rightly said, that we have different ethnic groups, and each ethnic group has got its own unique art form, customs, etc. Cultural exchange program for all the groups in the Northeast region is indeed need of the hour for revival and reconnecting with our roots and reaffirming our identity.
Mr. Sharma, that's very, very, very apt. Now, talking about the goals to be pursued for cultural exchange as a bridge for better relations and development of the Northeastern region, how can each state contribute to this? Again, Kong Kharjana, would you like to mention something on this?
In my opinion, I will talk from the culture point of view. We can have a bridge for the gaps between the Northeastern states by having cultural exchange in the field of music, dance, and then in the field of art and craft, so that we'll learn and get to know each other, even continue the relationship, having all these types of programs which we have used to organize every time, you know, from the state with other states. And we do have programs which have been organized by the Northeast Zone Cultural Center. Mm-hmm. And through that also we are able to share different cultures that we have. They are organizing programs which really help in building the friendship, relationship, improving the understand each other, and the tendency of acceptance is also there.
All right, let's hear from Mr. Barua.
Can you hear me now?
Yes, I can hear you.
Good evening again.
Very good evening to you.
It's a great pleasure that you are using the medium of radio, because it's 1st July 1948. Both Shillong and Guwahati went on air, and that was perhaps one of the greatest occasions of cultural exchange, when you had Ohomia songs being sung by Amina Walang and other, you know, artists from Shillong. So these were great.
So it's like celebrating the anniversary.
Yeah, I think. And then again, you know, we were talking about this exchange part of the issue.
Yes.
My idea would be that we must first know each other. We are the Northeast, the eight sisters. There is a cultural affinity because we have something in common. Our lifestyles are common in the sense that the whole society on the Northeast is based on agriculture and agricultural practices being in and around the same time and the same way of doing it. Then the second unity would come in the bamboo culture, the intense use of bamboo in our lifestyles. Then again, the pre-harvest, post-harvest dances. Then again, you have the Kamekhe influence of the snake goddesses here in Manipur, here in Shillong, and maybe even in the Naga tribal societies. So I feel that the first platform that we should go is to know each other. Let us know that about our cultural festivals. Let us know the dances that happen, the Nongkram that is happening, or maybe Sutsuk Mansiam happening there, or the Govindaji temple functions that happen in Ras, or the Lai Haroba, or the vigorous Naga dances, or the Lepcha dances of Sikkim. This is all we first have to know each other and thereby establish a bridge amongst us. The bridge was already there.
Yes.
In fact, today morning I was writing an article that, you know, Guwahati University till 72 was the only university in the Northeast.
Mm-hmm.
And then the strongest colleges that represented culturally in that youth festival held by the Guwahati University was DM College of Imphal. Then you had the Anthony and the Edmunds College of Shillong. And then you had other colleges who were coming, and all the people of the Northeast used to get together, exhibit their cultures. And, you know, there was this massive cultural interaction in between them, for which reason music of the Northeast was circulated among the youth in the youth festival, and thereby it spread out to the homes later on. I mean, that somehow bridge has been broken. I think the NEZCC has a great role to play there, and we from Assam are also pursuing at our level, because we have the advantage of having being a member of both EZCC and NEZCC, that we can all, first of all, let us know about the cultures of all the states. Once we know each other, then we'll find what is the commonality. Once we know what is commonality, we can find the bonds amongst us and go ahead.
Yes, so your points are really well taken. You've mentioned some very important points that might come up again during the discussion. I think we are connected now to Mr. Sothu from Kohima.
First thing I'd like to share with you, the main goal should be, I think, to understand each other. The outside world, that the mainland India calls us, not by our states, but they call us as the northern states. Therefore, I think it's important that we, the northern states, understand each other well through our culture. The next thing I think I can share on is about the contribution that just you mentioned about. Each state have a lot of our own tribes. And Nagaland being a state where we have been divided into so many tribes, I think it is this culture that can really bring us together, because the things that we do, the things that we practice, Mr. Borra has already mentioned, will really bring us together and understand each other better.
Now, talking about cultural exchange for better relations and development, as you mentioned, why is there need to promote cultural exchange, especially now in the 21st century? And how do we actually contribute to its promotion?
Yes, after all these years, we need to start talking about our cultural relations, because that is our root. We started with our culture, and it is through our culture that we are understood. Therefore, the need is big that we go back to our root and understand each other a little more through our culture and our traditional practice.
We need to find strength.
Can I come in at this moment?
Yes, sure.
You know, what to add to Aribam's words, I think basically what we have really to take care of is, you know, protection of our and preservation of our own cultures as living traditions. What has happened is that there are a lot of external influences coming into our cultures, as a result of which a lot of things are getting lost. Now, let's say I, as a person who had grown up in Shillong, had seen a lot more of the cultural practices happening in the public platform. And now that public platform has been transformed into the state central library. Now what has happened is that these are all folk cultures. Mm-hmm. Folk cultures must live among the people. Unless it is lives among the people as a participatory culture, if it's transformed into a stage culture, something to exhibit, mm-hmm. I don't think it can really last in the long run. So, you know, the individuality of the cultures of each tribe, of each state, first has to be protected, preserved, and I think as a member of the NEZCC since inception, I've been pressurizing them that please utilize a common place for building up this musical archive, the visual archive, and see that culture is promoted as a living tradition among all the tribes. This apparently, unless we keep on doing, our variety may be lost forever. And this is something, if it's lost forever, I think we'll lose our identity. And I think the whole identity crisis, which is the base of all problems in each of the northeastern states, create even more bigger problems on the political and social level. So I feel that preserving culture in situ among the people is all the more important in the present context when we have so much of external influences coming in and trying to change the lifestyles. Because see, we were agriculturalists till 10 years ago, 20 years ago, but most of us have become urbanized now. Now, once you are taken out of the situation where your culture was living around you, and you come to a city which is nameless, homeless, and you're one of the many citizens there, you find yourself culturally lost.
That's
now, how do you preserve your culture in an urban environment is also another issue which all of us who are associated with culture have to really think about. Then we can talk about exchanges, and the exchanges also has to be in dealing with the problems that is affecting culture as a living tradition amongst all our people.
From our state, we are trying very hard to preserve our own culture by having different programs every now and then for us also, but we are trying very hard to preserve, bring the culture alive, and then to imbibe the spirit of love for the own culture. So we are trying very hard from the department, and we hope that we will be successful in the near future.
All right. What about Mr. Sharma? Would you like to mention something on this?
It would help in integrating the ideas and the culture of the Northeastern states, thereby bridging the misconception and the differences among the different communities of the Northeastern states, and it shall promote the importance of preserving the cultural heritage, which shall have a wider understanding, audience, and publicity. In my state, we have got varied programs taken up, and we have met so many cultural exchange programs like Manipur Sangai Festival, Shiroi Festival. In such festivals, all the artist groups from the Northeastern regions are invited. It is aimed to provide a suitable platform to experience the varied cultural aspects and also to share their culture to our people. We have had other Northeast Zonal Cultural Center also has taken up steps like Discover Northeast, where artists from different states are bring together for about 1 or 2 weeks and perform to remote villages, so knowing each other very well. And recently, in the last month of June, we have organized a musical festival called Roots, a musical journey of Northeast folk music and instrument. And many leading artists, and they have performed, and we have made an experiment. And it is this amazing, the outcome is very good. Such a kind of exchange program has developed a unity and a belief in ourselves. And a cultural exchange program for all the groups in the Northeastern region is, as I mentioned earlier, is indeed the need of the hour.
Barua would like to mention something.
In diplomacy, culture is always the first step. You know, so as you can see that ICCR is there and has been around since independence, because the founding fathers of the country felt that unless we have a cultural integration with the rest of the world and establish a person-to-person contact at nothing to give and nothing to lose, but take something from one and take something from and give something to the other. This is a great Rabindranath word which says that
milite
lage milat. Milate lage. You know, that kind of a give and take which happens establishes a person-to-person contact through culture. You look through commonalities and then you can talk about trade, commerce and mutual interest. Mm-hmm. So culture always precedes diplomacy, and I think once we can make an entry culturally into any country, we make an entry into the hearts of the other people. And once you enter the hearts, a lot of things become much more easier. And I think a great example of that is the intense cultural activity that is happening in between India or the northeastern states and Bangladesh in the recent few years, which has opened up such a lot of things that from the 1st of July, we are having flights from Guwahati directly to Dhaka.
Yes.
And I think that will expand to the northeastern states.
Yes.
Myanmar will be in close connectivity. So this cultural exchange.
So it's
but
all
then
about
again,
mutual
I think we have another point I would like to make here as a continuing of point of the something which Sharma had said is that the class cultural influences that have happened within our northeastern states is something we have not yet realized. If Aribam Sharma would come, would the earlier Aribam Shyam Sharma would be so pleased to see that every Assamese drama now has more or less a thangta sequence. Or whenever there's a dance sequence within a drama, the choreography that comes in from Lai Haroba is also there. Then so far as choral music is concerned, we find the Naga influences coming into music and drama of the Northeast.
So recognizing these implications of cultural exchange activities that we mentioned, what are these strategies to be undertaken or initiated?
If you ask me, then there should be a program in PPC at any and all India radio stations of the entire Northeast that, Guwahati should be broadcasting us 1 week of Khasi songs, 1 week Manipuri songs, 1 week, I think, Naga music, these kind of exchanges, if they happen, and especially in prime time, I'm sure that even a disinterested person would be forced to listen to our music and songs in and around.
Yes, I would be proud to mention that, from our station, we have that every day. In fact, we have programs highlighting the different folk songs, cultural songs from different states of the Northeast. And we are proud of that.
Yeah. So that kind of an integration would definitely help.
Mr. Sothu, you're a little quiet.
Well, I wanted to intervene, but
yes.
Then,
please feel free to intervene at any moment.
Yeah. When you were talking about challenges, I think the distance and the artificial borders, I think these are some things which are keeping us from getting connected. The other thing I feel is the acceptability of one's culture by the other state. As a Naga, if I listen to a Bihu song, I should be able to enjoy it and accept that because we belong to one area. Yes, likewise, if an Assamese listens to my Sikri song, I think the Assamese should also enjoy that.
Yes.
And I think that which we have to overcome.
Those are just temporary walls, actually. We can easily break them.
Exactly, exactly. Temporary walls which we can
overcome. So it's all about cultivating mutual understanding and trust between different cultures and, resolves to peaceful resolutions.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, right.
And I think it would be very important discussing about the stakeholders involved, in bringing about this cultural exchange. So how about listening to Mr. Sharma, talking about the stakeholders?
In this context, there will be one organizing advisory committee at intergovernment level. And education department, culture departments, and this will be the major stakeholders and the organizations like EJCC and NEJCC, ICCR. They have important roles to play, and more importantly, the artists and the students, because they are the ones to invite the culture for prosperity and posterity. One way forward is that inclusion of studies of culture of Northeast region in the syllabus of all educational institutions.
Exactly.
School, college, universities, they are not just states compulsorily, because such history like such lifestyle, traditions, customs, ritual, etc., they will have wider coverage, people of all kinds, otherwise exchange of performing arts confines to the artists only. So development and a better relations depends on understanding and respect of our culture. So that's why stakeholders, this will be multi-pronged approach, and all the peoples of the Northeast have a major role to play.
Very true. What you mentioned about, bringing in the traditional or the, cultural exchange syllabus also into the mainstream line, in institutions. And I think Kong Karjana would also like to add on this.
In each and every schools, and then even the colleges and institutions, they are introducing our own culture of the state, as well as spreading it to other parts of the country and the world itself.
I'm also aware of some research being done, you know, on traditional dances, you know, the choreographic that is involved. Is
really yes, from the department, we have done many documentations on all those.
And is something like this being done in Imphal, Mr. Sharma? And I'm sure you can really enlighten us more on this.
Yes, of course, we have got Manipur University of Culture. Mm-hmm. This is the first of its kind, I think, in the entire Northeast. We have got the University of Culture, mm-hmm. where all aspects of cultures are taught. We have got Government College of Music and Dances. Also, we have got Tribal Research and Study Center, Nagadi University for Tribal Studies. And in the Manipur University also, we have got different departments for culture. In Manipur, especially, we have got varied platforms and institutions. And moreover, we have got in the private sector also different NGOs, also civil service, cultural organizations.
Entities, including the public and the private sectors, and as we mentioned, yes. all the institutions, should build a horizontal and active partnership which can promote each other's objectives more effectively. And I think it's surely going to work out.
Can I mention something here?
Yes.
Yeah. I just wanted to give you an example of what Nagaland is doing regarding the music and the culture, so that if it is good, other people can also follow. Nagaland, I think, is the only government where we have a music department. So through this, we propagate our culture, our traditions, and of course, the contemporaries too. We call that as a music task force. In addition to that, Nagaland Board of School Education has textbook fully dedicated to the culture and traditions of Nagaland.
Okay, that's
so.
That's
these are the two things which I thought I'll
yes,
let other people
thank
also
you for
know.
Sharing
yes.
that. All right, so I think that brings us finally to the end of the deliberation this evening. Very enriching and informative deliberation on the topic cultural exchange for better relations and development of the Northeastern region. And rightly said, cultural differences should not separate us from each other, but rather cultural diversity brings a collective strength that can benefit all of humanity. I take the privilege to thank our panelists this evening, Mr. Aribam Sivadas Sharma, Mrs. Deek Harjana, Mr. Swapanil Barwaf, and Mr. Hovithal Sothu. This program was produced by J. Gangthi, and we would also thank the engineers on duty, Rahul, Sushish, and Hoping. Thank you, dear listeners, for being a part of our discussion this evening. This is your host, Dr. Bonnie M. Nichols, signing off from the studios of the Northeastern Service of All India Radio.